Let's explore what options are available with Zoom Phone on a mobile device during an active phone call. To start, I have my phone unlocked, but I am not in the Zoom app. Here's a call coming in now. On my iPhone, the incoming call appears with the option to either accept the call or decline the call. If I was already in the Zoom app, the incoming call would display even more information and options. For example, if the call comes in directly to your number or extension, nothing will look out of the ordinary. However, if you are a member of a call queue or a shared line group, different information and options will appear here. I'll tap to accept, and I'm immediately brought to the call in the Zoom app. Here, the caller ID information is shown, and you can tap to see further details about the caller. Also shown is a running timer logging the duration of the current call and rows of additional options, followed by the red phone button to end the call. In the upper left corner, you can tap the downward arrow icon to minimize the call to access the rest of the Zoom app. In the upper right, we can tap to see if enhanced encryption is active for this call and the current level of call quality. To mute or unmute your microphone at any time, tap the mute button. To switch to speakerphone, tap speaker. If you have a Bluetooth device connected to your phone, the speaker icon will be replaced by a Bluetooth icon. Tap the icon to reveal all of the audio options available and select which audio source you would like to use. Tapping on the keypad gives you access to enter numbers during the call. For example, maybe you need to press 1 to reach the sales department or press 0 to reach an operator. When in use, the keypad replaces your basic in-call options, but you can navigate back by tapping on Hide Keypad. To add an additional person to a call, tap on Add Call to search for a specific contact or dial a number to include them in the conversation. When ready, tap the Merge button to add the two separate calls together. By tapping on the caller ID information, you can easily see who is involved in this particular call and drop one of them as necessary. From time to time, you might need to place a call on hold. Once you tap hold, the caller will hear hold music until you take them off of hold. To transfer a call to another user, tap on Transfer. Either manually enter a number or tap the person icon in the bottom left to search your contacts. Once you have picked who to transfer the call to, a box appears giving you three options. A warm transfer allows you to speak to the new agent privately before transferring the call. This is great because it allows you to bring them up to speed regarding the call, hopefully providing a better overall experience for the caller and the new agent taking over the call. The second option is a direct transfer. This option connects the call immediately to the new agent, which can speed things up, but might not be as friendly to the caller or the new agent. The final option is to transfer the call straight to the individual's voicemail. To record a call for later reference or review, tap Record.
This call is being recorded.
An audible alert is played to inform everyone that the call is being recorded. Recorded calls can easily be referenced in the History subsection once they are completed. If you happen to make multiple recordings during a single call by starting and stopping the recording, you will get a single merged recording file once the call has completed. Tucked under More are additional options. When on a mobile device, the option to switch to carrier is available. If you're experiencing poor or limited data connectivity, choosing this option may improve the call quality until you can get a better signal. When selecting this option, you'll need to enter what phone number to switch the call to, and then tap Switch. At the top of the app, Zoom will note that the call is switching as the call is transferred to the number that you entered. In this instance, I transferred the call to my mobile number. Once I tap to answer, the call will end on Zoom Phone. Tapping to park a call is similar to transferring a call. However, in this case, rather than transferring the call to a specific person, the call is placed in a hold-like state and a code is generated. The code is briefly displayed at the top of the Zoom app. If you happen to miss the code, navigate to the Lines subsection where you will see the call parked, how long it has been parked, and the code to retrieve the call. Since I parked this call, I can also pick it up by tapping on the blue phone button. Anyone who enters the parked call's code will be connected with the call. Once again, under More, tap Handoff to Room to seamlessly transition a call over to a Zoom room. Zoom will attempt to detect any nearby Zoom rooms, or you can manually enter a sharing key to make the switch. Sometimes a call requires more than just audio, and you can elevate a call to a Zoom meeting with a single tap of the Meet button. If the other person is using Zoom, they will see a meeting invite pop up on their screen to quickly join the meeting. It's straightforward and easy. However, if they are on a typical phone, they will join the meeting as an audio-only participant. Anyone who is an audio-only participant can be identified in two ways. First, only a phone will appear in the participants list next to their name, and secondly, a phone icon will appear where a profile picture or their video would normally display. Should an audio-only attendee want or need to see what is happening in the meeting, in the participants list, tap on Invite to use a variety of methods to send them the meeting invitation. And there you have it. You are now ready to use Zoom Phone on the go.